Building big assemblies in SolidWorks can be a very tedious and slow process, especially if you find yourself always using the same components and thus the same mates over and over again. Luckily for you, SolidWorks has a set of tools that you can use to automate your mates in the form of mate references, which are pretty much a way to teach SolidWorks the mates you always use for a pair of components when mating them together, just as you're seeing on screen right now. So, let's find out how to do it. The most frequent case to use mate references are when using fasteners, such as bolts, nuts, washers, etc. Normally, what you would do is just insert one of these components, and then add some mates, and you would do that a lot of times. Now let's head over to the part file. In the Features tab, all the way to the Reference Geometry dropdown, you'll see the Mate Reference tool. Here, SolidWorks will ask for 1 up to 3 mates to automatically add to this bolt when inserting it inside an assembly in a certain way that we'll see in just a moment. The primary reference entity will be the first mate to add, the secondary the second one, and the tertiary the third one, in case you add a third one. You'll see that for each of the reference entities, we have 5 types of mates to choose from, and also 4 kinds of alignments. For this component and others similar, you would of course want to add the concentric mate as the primary reference, and then this face as the secondary reference entity. As for the alignments, to understand them, let's look a little bit closer to how we would do it manually. Let's look at the mates we've just added. I'm going to suppress this one for a little bit. And let's take a closer look to the concentric mate. We'll see below that we actually have here 2 options for the alignments. Right now we have an aligned alignment, but if we had chosen the anti-aligned alignment, our bolt would be facing the opposite direction. Of course, that's not what I want, but these 2 same options are the ones that you can choose in the mate reference alignment dropdown. Now, as for the coincident mate, the logic will be the same, but in this case, you actually want an anti-aligned alignment, because if we chose the aligned alignment too, you could understand as those 2 faces overlapping each other. So that's not what you want. Let's delete this component now and let's head over back to the part file. Now that we know what we just saw, then we would have to choose the aligned alignment here and then here the anti-aligned one. And that would be pretty much it, but there's a better way to do this when using these kinds of components that have an edge that shares the coincident face and the concentric face that you'll use to define the mates. What I mean by this is that, let's start over again, and we'll just choose this edge. You'll notice that there won't be any other mate options, because SolidWorks is smart enough to understand what we want to do. We just need to define this alignment, and now, when we use the insert components, you need to click the component you want to add, and just put your mouse nearby a circular edge where you would place this bolt. You'll see that next to my mouse pointer, there's this icon. That means that my mate references are working. Let's take a look at the mates that SolidWorks just added. Indeed, we have the concentric mate and the coincident one. Now, for a washer, you would do pretty much the same. And in this case, since you're going to be adding a number of components, not necessarily the same a lot of times, I suggest that you pin this window and then you just select this component first. There's my mate references. And then click on the other one. And there you go. Now let's talk about more complex components. For example, if you build machines or if you use a lot of aluminum profiles, you'll have to use end caps or gussets a lot of times. So in the case of the end caps, what you would do is to add a coincident mate between 2 faces of these components, then a concentric one to align them, and you would need another mate so this end cap doesn't spin and it's in the right orientation. For this other one, you could choose a coincident mate too and 2 concentric ones, and that would be good. Let's leave the gussets at last. So for these kinds of cases, you will need to actually add a set of made references. That means that this piece, the end cap and the profile, will have to have the same made reference with the same name. Let's examine this one first. What I want for this piece, with the made reference that I want, is that this face will be the coincident one and it will be anti-aligned, as we've just learned. Then I will add a concentric mate using this circular entity. It can have any orientation. This means that SolidWorks will automatically add one of these options and it won't reverse your mates. So that's another way to do this. And I will also use a plane that will be coincident. And for this case, it can also be any aligned, so it doesn't matter if it's aligned or anti-aligned. So you'll notice that for the reference entities, you could actually use faces, edges, vertices, or even reference geometry, like this plane. And if we go to the profile, you'll see that I actually have the same made reference in both faces. So again, the same name, that's very important. And the same combination, first the face, coincident and aligned, just like the end cap. Then a concentric mate, and for this part I can actually use the top plane as my mid plane reference entity. It will work the same as the plane that I created on the end cap. And as you're just seeing, you could have multiple instances of the same mate reference, just with different faces, or multiple mate references with different names. The same goes for this other end cap. I have this mate reference with this other name. In this case, I only have to choose this face as coincident, anti-aligned, and these other two concentric mates with any alignment. And if I head over to the big profile, you'll see the same thing. I have two instances of the same mate reference with the same name as the end cap, and the same combination, coincident and anti-aligned, and two concentric mates with any alignment. So if done properly, I can add these two components just with a single click and in both of my faces. Now let's see, if I try to add this end cap to this other profile, you'll see that there's not quite the match. So SolidWorks will try to add some made references, but since these two parts don't have the same combination, it just won't work. But if I choose the right one, things go great. Lastly, let's focus on the gussets. You'll notice that certain components can be actually very similar. For example, I have this gusset and I also have this other one. So they're pretty much the same shape, just a different size. That means that I can actually add the same made reference with the same name for these two components. So for these two same gussets, the principle is very easy. I will add first a face that will be coincident and anti-aligned, but then I need to add another face that's also coincident but aligned, and I will use the front plane as a mid-plane reference entity. So why first coincident anti-aligned and then coincident aligned? That's actually because I want to add these gussets in 8 different ways. What I mean is that I could have the gusset connecting these two faces, or maybe these two faces. Hell, I can even use this other face with another profile, and also the same goes upside. So right now let's just focus on these two faces, the small ones, in both directions. So it's a little hard to teach SolidWorks the proper alignment sometimes, but if we do it right, it will work great. So let's head over to my profile. You'll see that I have 4 made references with the same name. Of course, the only thing that changes is going to be the faces. So for example, in this made reference, I will actually use this plane as equivalent of the coincident anti-aligned mate from the gusset. I could choose this face, but it's better to choose something that connects these two faces. If you just choose this face, then the mate reference will only work if you hover your mouse over this face and not over this one. So for this case, it's better to have, for example, a plane. Then I use this face, coincident aligned, and again my top plane as a mid plane for reference. The other mid reference combination would be the same, just changing the first reference entity. That means that I have first the mid reference for this face and then for this other face. That means that I have to do the same thing with the other side, using first the plane 2 and then the plane 1, but using this face as a secondary reference entity. Again, first plane 1, then this face, and then the same top plane. And you'll see that this other gusset has the same principle. So if done properly, we can do this. Let's choose first this angle gusset. I'll hover my mouse anywhere near this face and take a look. SolidWorks automatically knows where I want to put this. If for any reason your gusset is not properly oriented, you could press the tab key and SolidWorks will try to align it again. But this works great. Now let's try the other face. Again, great. That pop-up menu sometimes pops out. And now let's use the other gusset. So that's it. Of course, this required a lot of trial and error, so you will probably have to make a couple of tests for this to work sometimes. But again, if done properly, you can save a lot of time when building your big assemblies. Just try to analyze how you would manually add the mates that you use for these two component combination, make a few tests, and keep trying. If using the faces or vertices or edges of any of the two parts won't work, then start creating some reference geometry, planes, points, even surfaces, those kind of things. Of course, these are only simple examples that I do happen to use at my work, so for more complex cases, you'll probably struggle a lot more. So that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you found this useful, leave a like, subscribe, and I'll see you on the next video. Remember, work smarter, not harder.